She's famous.
You're behind it, you're fine, you've got plenty of room over here. How's everybody feeling?
There.
Sore?
Yeah.
Feeling good for today? We're gonna open up the hips a little bit, especially your sore hip flexors, might be breaking up for you. We're gonna keep it low to the mat here, restorative, okay? I'm gonna have a few moms trickle in here shortly. When you're ready, let's just come to our mats. We're gonna find child's pose. So I want you to bring your knees wide. Just bring your big toes together to touch behind you. Just sink your hips back and down. Put the arms straight forward. And just rest your forehead on the mat here. And just begin to arrive. Let your weight be heavy. Just let your breath deepen here for a moment. And start to lengthen those inhales. Just deepen the exhales. Take deep breaths in all the way to the base of your ribs. And just exhale out of your nose. Take a deep breath in. And deep breath out. And one more here. Inhale. And exhale. Let's inhale and walk the hands to the right. Now I'm mirroring you guys. I'm going backwards. Breathe in your, to your side body as you lengthen. Just root your left side down. As you stretch to the side here. Back to the center from here. And inhale, walk the hands to the left side this time. Just breathe into your side body here as you root the right hip down. More breaths, breathing into your side body here. Feel that stretch. Let's slowly return to our center. Walk the palms in. And inhale to tabletop. Let's bring the hands directly beneath you. Knees right beneath your hips. And inhale. Let's find our cow pose. Let the tail reach up. Let your crown lift high. And exhale. Cat pose. Just feel the shoulder blades pull away from your spine. Let your tail tuck under. And inhale to cow. Let the heart be soft. And exhale. Cat pose. Push through the hands and just draw your tail down. And inhale to cow. And exhale to cat. To neutral, back to your tabletop position. Inhale, kneeling side plank. Now from here, let's stretch that right foot back. Sweep that right hand open to the sky. Just open the chest here. Now if you want, you can stack the feet for your advanced people. Just rainbow the hips up a little bit. Slide that bottom knee back down to the mat. If you don't have it down already, press into that left knee. Let's lighten up this left hand in front and lift the torso up with it. Find your V pose. We're just lifting this one arm up. Open the chest here. Reach that right hand towards the right toes behind you. So that right hand falls to the right chin. or to your knee, and just reach the left arm over your ear. Just draw the low ribs in, and just press down through the left knee. Pull a little bit deeper towards the right. Got it. Beautiful. Breath in here. Exhale. Let's find Stargazer. Bring that left hand to the top of your mat. Let's root it down. Stretch that right arm along your ear, lifting up here. Let the tailbone drive down. Let your hips push gently forward. Just draw your right rib cage back. Just begin to rotate your torso up towards the ceiling. And take a deep breath in here. Deep breath out. Deep breaths in here. And deep breath out. Exhale to tabletop. Let's bring that right hand down. Lower the knee back down to the mat here. Knees under the hips, palms under the shoulders. Let's inhale and step that left foot back this time. Just peel it down. Stretch the left hand to the ceiling. And again here, side plank if you like. You can stack your feet here. Just rainbow the hips out. Back down to the mat, just plant it down for some stability. Just root through that right knee, lighten up that front hand, the right hand. Let's find our gate post, lift the torso. Just open your chest here as you stretch that left hand towards your left foot. Just lowering it down to the shin, draping the right arm across the ear. Just twist your torso up towards the ceiling. Take a deep breath in here. And deep breath out. A few more breaths on your own. Top of the mat here, just stretching that left arm along the ear. Now again here, press the hips forward, let the tailbone pull under, press the hips gently forward, just rotate the chest up towards the ceiling, just take a deep breath in, deep breath out. Down under the shoulder, let the knees come down to the mat, right under your hips. Now let's find our puppy dog pose. So we're already here, let's let the hips stay over the knees and walk those palms forward, 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 just as far as you can comfortably go here. Let the chest start to melt towards your mat. Maybe your chin can rest here on your mat, or if that's too much, just rest your forehead here. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, soften your chest as you stretch. Down, tops of the feet down, scoop the tailbone under. From there, just begin to lift the heart forward and up. Let the shoulder blades pull together. Let your hands kind of traction the mat back. Deep breath in. And exhale. Let the chest lower back down to your mat. the same time, opposite arm out in front, left arm, extend it out. Exhale, let's pull that elbow to the knee. Inhale, reach the arm out, press the heel back. And exhale, draw it in. Are you too far to the wall back there? If you are, you can move forward a little bit. Inhale, let's reach out. And let's bend that right knee behind and grab for that foot with the left hand. Just capture the outer part of the foot here. And turn the torso forward. Rotate the left rib cage down. From there, just keep hugging the belly in here. Soften your chest as your shoulder blades pull together. Gently kicking into the hands. Think of turning the right knee to point downward. And let that shin bone point up towards the ceiling. Just keep kicking a little bit more. Take another inhale here. Exhale, let's release, but stay up. Stretch the foot back and reach that left arm overhead. Inhale, deep breath. Exhale, let's connect that elbow back to the knee. And inhale, stretch it long. And exhale, knee down and hand down. Let's find our tabletop. Move to the other side. So let's press that left leg back this time. Reach that right hand out in front. Exhale, curl the spine, connect that elbow to the knee. And inhale, extend the arm out. Extend that leg out long. And exhale, draw it in. Inhale, lengthen the limbs out long. And let's bend into that left knee and reach back for it. Right hand back. Capture the outside of the foot. Just rotate the right shoulder forward. Turn the right rib cage to point down. Just point that left knee towards the ground. And hug the lower belly in. Slide the shoulder blades towards each other. And let that heart soften forward. Just kick gently into the hands out there. Deep breath in. Stay for the exhale. And one more here. Inhale. Press the ground away with that front palm. Exhale. Let's release, but stay up. Stretch the foot back. Reach the left arm, right arm overhead. And inhale deeply. Exhale. Connect that elbow back to the knee. And inhale. Stretch it long. Exhale. Let's return to the tabletop. Let's reach through the L's of our hands here. Just tuck those toes behind you. Get ready to lift off here with the knees coming up and reach the hips up and back. Find your downward facing dog. Just push the mat forward with your hands. Feel all the knuckle pads pressing down. Let your shoulder blades lift up towards the pinky fingers. Just try to soften your neck here, soften your jaw, use your ankles. Kind of pedal your feet if you want, soften your ankles towards the mat. If you've got any soreness in the calves, just take a deep breath in here. And a deep breath out. Let's lower our knees down to the mat from here. Press the hips back. Just sweep those feet out in front to find a seated position here. And let's find Gomukhasana, cow face pose. We're going to pull this left knee in and just lay it down on the mat, pointing that knee kind of at the top of your mat here. And from there, step that right foot over. Outside edge of that knee. Just kind of wiggle the feet back so that the knees come towards stacking. Now again, if this is uncomfortable, go back to regular. Easy seat, just crisscross. So let's just kind of press those pinky toes down. Dip in the pose. Hands on either side of your hips, just lengthen the spine as you sit. And let's lift up here. Lengthen, press through the crown. Exhale, start to walk the hands forward. Just fold here. Let yourself fold over your legs. Just press gently into your palms. Let your outer hips root down. Just kind of soften your face here. Breathing deeply.
Thank you.
Shavasana on the second side. This time, draw that right knee in first and lay that right leg down. Kind of pointing that knee at the top of the mat. Sweeping that other foot. Step that left foot outside edge of the right thigh. And start to wiggle the feet back. So get the knees come towards stacking here in front. Flex both feet out. Lay the hands on either side of your hips for a moment just to try to lengthen the spine as you sit. Lift up. Lift through the sternum, inhale nice and tall, and let's exhale, begin to fold here. Start to fold gently over your legs. Swap the hands out in front, drape the shoulders down. Let your chin tuck in towards your chest. Just let your outer hips reach down into your mat. Let them fold over your legs. told you some intro to, or you may go a little bit deeper than that. Wherever you land, just try to let your chin tuck in towards your chest. Start to walk our hands back in towards our shins and sit up nice and tall. Release the hands behind. Let's release the feet back to the mat here. Just plant them down. Knees pointed up. And again, here one more time if you want. Swing those knees side to side. Just let a windshield wiper side to side to neutralize the hips. Let's find the firelock on that second side. This time, draw the left knee in. Just lay that left shin bone down, parallel to the front of your mat. Just cross that right ankle over, over that left knee. Let that right foot kind of hang off the side. Just feel the inner thighs draw away from your midline here as you press the hands down by your hips. Just kind of draw the pubic bone downward towards your mat. Inhale, reach it tall, press through the sit bones, nice and tall here. Exhale, let's start to crawl the hands forward, fold over your legs, just let your chin tuck in towards your chest, press gently into your palms and just soften your shoulders down. One final time here, bringing the feet to your mat again, planting them down flat here, and again, those knees fall side to side, just neutralizing the hips. Let's go ahead and plant the hands here in front and step it back to downward facing dog. Let's press firmly through our palms as we let the ankles soften again towards the floor, hips facing up towards the ceiling. Feel those feet here if you'd like. And inhale, let's stretch that right foot up and back. Just down dog kick here. Keep your hips square to the mat as you drive through that right heel. And exhale, let's step that right foot wide outside of your hand for lizard pose. Let that back knee lower down if you'd like. And just relax into your inner and outer hip. Let the shoulders be soft. Now again, you don't have to lower that back knee. If you want more to stretch, you can lift it up. You can even come down onto your forearms if you'd like to advance this pose. Just take a moment to find a comfortable position. Mm-hmm. once you're there. Take deep breaths. Pose. Just grab that left foot behind and pull the left heel into your glute. Just open the chest here to the side. Just slide the right ribcage back. You can also advance this if you like. You can come down further onto your forearm. If you feel like it, go for it. Just let your hips descend towards the mat. Reach chest out. Inhale and open the chest. One more time to the side. Exhale. Let's gently release that back foot. Place the right hand back down to the center hip. Turn those toes forward. Come high up to the palms. And inhale. Deep breath in here. Lift that hind knee. Exhale. Soften completely. Just coming onto the palms here. Tuck those back toes. Let's press through the hands and step it back to downward facing dog. Lift the hips up and back. And inhale. Let's stretch that other foot up and back. Left foot up and back. Now just keep the hips pointing at your mat and drive that left foot away. Down dog kick. Exhale. Let's step that left foot outside of that left hand. Same thing over here for lizard pose. Lower that back knee if you want. Lift that right foot back as you drop it down or lift it back up if you like. Relax here. Just let your hands fall under your shoulders or your forearms under your shoulders. Here, let those knees point up at the sky and just curl your spine all the way down. And let's lay that left leg long and pull that right knee into your right rib cage. Just give a little hug here, a little squeeze. Let the weight be heavy in your sacrum as you pull. Let the shoulders soften. And just breathe into the outer right hip. You can rotate that ankle joint around and around if you'd like. Maybe clockwise and counterclockwise with the foot. Just constantly switching directions. Let's switch sides from here. Bring that right foot down. Let's bring the left knee into the chest this time. In here, give it a squeeze. Rotate that foot round and around. Hips be heavy, and just feel that stretch in your sacrum, in your outer right hip. Soften the shoulders down, and just soften your face. And inhale here. Exhale, let's release and just bring both feet back to the earth here. And knees pointed up. Let's extend that left leg this time to the sky. And same thing here, find that figure four stretch. Just cross the left ankle over that right knee and weave the left hand through the legs this time. Just grab that hamstring with both palms and recline back. Just relaxing here, drawing the hamstring in towards your chest. Soften your hips, soften your face. Take one more inhale here to the stretch. And exhale, let's release both feet back to the mat. Let's extend both legs to the sky and just begin to shimmy the shoulder blades under you. Just keep the neck in neutral, the gaze right where it is to the ceiling. And just start to curl your tailbone off the ground if you want to move towards shoulder stand. Stay here in waterfall if you'd like, palms facing upward. But if you want to try this, let's go towards plow pose from shoulder stand. Lift the feet up and let the feet land behind you on the floor. Now, if you feel any uncomfortable pain or pressure in your neck, I want you to come right back down, or you can just walk your elbows in and place the hands in your lower back for the plow pose. Again, if this is too much, I want you to come right back down, just elevate the legs, and even move towards a wall for waterfall pose if you like, just taking all the pressure off. Inhale, deep breath in here. Stay for the exhale. And then let's release the hands down to the mat. Push through your palms as you slowly curl the spine all the way down to the ground. And plant the feet back on the mat. And let's extend both legs back to the ceiling. Stay in waterfall again if you'd like here, palms facing upward. Or you can move towards shoulder stand. Peel up your back, mid-back, and upper back. And just kind of push the spine towards your chin as you stretch the legs up to the ceiling. Just bring the hands to your low back. Drive the triceps down into your mat. Mm-hmm. ceiling. Exhale, let's release the legs down, kind of behind your head here for a moment. And release the hands down to the mat. Slowly roll all the way down to your mat. Placing the feet back on your mat. Let's extend the right leg towards the sky here. And just place the hands back behind the hamstring or the calf. And just feel yourself kind of pulling that leg downward into your hip socket first. And from there, just gently start to draw the leg closer towards your chest, towards you. You can move your palms up towards the calf if you want. Just getting that leg closer and closer with each breath out. Deep inhales. Exhale to feel more of that stretch. Take one more breath in here. And exhale. Let's plant that right foot next to the left. And extend the other leg up. Left leg towards the sky this time. Let's wrap the hands around the hamstring or the calf. Just take a deep breath in here. Pull that left leg down into the hip socket. From there, just start to stretch that hamstring. Pull that leg back towards you. Take a big breath in here. And exhale, step that left foot back down on your mat. And let's roll onto our right side and make our way all the way to our bellies. So as we're on our belly, we're gonna bring our right ear to the mat. I'm gonna mirror you guys again, so I'm going backwards. You're gonna align those elbows in line with your shoulders, goalpost arms. Just soften your shoulders down into the mat. As you lay your right ear down, just keep that right ear and right forearm rooted down. You're gonna walk this left hand down, push it into the ground by your chest, and roll onto that right shoulder from here. Let that left hip lift off the mat. Maybe slide that left foot back behind you. And just feel that stretch across the front of the right chest and shoulder. Soften your face and just breathe deeply. Take one more inhale here. Exhale, let's release, come back to your belly. Let's start to stretch this right hand forward, just down in front. Push into it. Just kind of pick up your left palm here and turn that palm facing upwards. Slide it under that right armpit area. So we're just keeping this right shoulder down, crawling that right hand forward, and releasing the head back down into the mat. We feel a deep stretch across the outer left shoulder. Just soften your hips into the mat. Soften your face.
How you drown in the ocean? Keep us
inhale and exhale. Let's go ahead and slide this right knee out to the right side, kind of like you're doing tree pose on your belly. Just connect the sole of the foot to the inner thigh. And draw this right hand towards your heart center. Now let's lift it up, sweep it up to the ceiling, and open up. Peel that right shoulder back. Find your supine twist here. Just let the right hip slide back to step on your left. Just release the chest here. Turn the gaze over your right shoulder. Soften that right shoulder down towards the floor.
Nothing left to do. Can't you see it was all for you? How close is that to catch a glimpse of the moon? A faint trail.
Inhale one more time, deep breath in. And exhale. Let's roll back to the left and come to your belly again here. Just extend the legs up long. Find your goalpost arms again and just bring the left ear to your mat this time. Keep your left ear and your left forearm on the ground. Let's go ahead and step that right hand down by the chest. Push into it. Begin to roll gently onto that left shoulder this time. Just let that right hand lift up. Slide that right leg back. And just soften your shoulders. Let deep stretch across the front of the left chest and shoulder this time. Breathe deeply. Whatever side you did last time, you're doing the other side. How about that? It's funky when I mirror you guys. I turn some people around. I don't mean to, but I do. Stretch the left hand out in front this time. Just kind of push it into the mat or floor. Palm yourself up. Turn that right palm up. Slide it under. Thread the needle here. Sliding under that left armpit. Just work that left hand forward. Square your shoulders down towards the forearm. Soften your chin towards your chest. Just relax both hips into the mat. Soften your legs. Let's slide that left knee out this time to the left side. Stretch the left hand up and over to the ceiling. From there, slide that left shoulder back. Find your supine twist. And just let your hips stack here, one on top of the other. Turn the gaze over your left shoulder. Exhale. Let's go ahead and bring the left hand to the hip and shimmy towards the center of your mat here, rolling onto your back this time. Let's plant both feet on the mat, knees pointed up. Let's bring both knees in towards our chest for happy baby. Just open the knees a little bit wider than your rib cage and capture your outer feet and let the tail press down and let the low back press down. Just kind of flatten your spine against the mat here. Let the shoulders flatten towards the mat. Rock and roll on your spine a little bit if you like. Just gently roll the feet downward. Thank you. hands, release the feet. Squeeze the knees into the chest. One big bear hug here. Deep breath in. And exhale. Let the legs stretch out long. Separate the feet out wider than your hips. And just let the feet flop out to the sides of your mat here. Just work the shoulder blades under you. Turn the palms up. Be completely still. Shavasana. Stay here as long as you like, or maybe roll over to your right side, make your way up to an easy seated position. Thank you for sharing your practice with us this weekend. Namaste. Is it great?
See you Monday, 7:30. Big announcement. We have a big event next Saturday that Tammy and some of our sweat sisters are doing at Cross Breeze. I don't know if you know Gulf Breeze CrossFit, right? Is that the name of it? Gulf Breeze CrossFit. You want to tell them more?
Sure. It's a fundraiser for Special Olympics, and they're looking for teams of 10 people to do a roll, they call it a roll raiser. So it's, you use the rowing machine in between